Introducing Chef Nilka Hendrix, known from Hell's Kitchen. And in this special feature, we're going to prepare a light first course, and you know it's going to be healthy. It's the first of a special three-part Chefing It Up series. So let's get to it. It's me, Naja T, and today we have a wonderful surprise for you. We are Chefing It Up with Chef Nilka Hendrix here today from Hell's Kitchen. We have some wonderful, wonderful things that we're going to be eating today. Well, I'm going to be eating.
Yes.
You guys are going to be making. But hopefully you show us some good stuff. I know we have healthy stuff. You're all about healthy cooking.
Yes.
So, I mean, tell us a little bit about what we're going to be making today.
All right, well, right now, you know, it's all about balance with what you eat. Like a lot of us, we're running, we don't have time, we always want to stop at a fast food and pick something up. So it's all about implementing. And if I'm going to be somebody of, you know, be out there in the media, I want to implement something positive.
Yeah.
So what we're going to do is say we're going to do a nice salad with romaine lettuce, mix some mesclun greens, some cranberries, some dry walnuts, and, you know, mangoes. And we're going to make a nice raspberry vinaigrette.
Oh, yes. That sounds good.
So something simple, sweet, and it's summertime, so it's vibrant, fun, a lot of colors, and, you know, we should all think about how we have to be more conscious.
You know, here and now, it's all about living now and beyond. So we're going to get started into the salad. I'm so excited because everybody knows I love salad, and it's sweet, so I don't have to eat any fruit snacks.
Nah.
I can eat this and be, you know, okay and healthy at the same time. So we're gonna get started.
First thing, we're gonna start with the salad dressing because I like to get that out of the way.
Oh, okay.
Because that takes
longer. We're gonna make salad dressing.
Yes. Right in.
Bottle salad dressing is like, you know,
Good, but you don't know how long it's been on the shelf. And then how much sodium is in it. You know, how much preservatives are in it. So when you're doing it fresh, you know that what's in it.
Yeah.
And that way it tastes much better. I love doing everything fresh. I don't like opening the bottle and saying, oh, Chef Nilka did it. Never.
Right.
I have to know that my blood, sweat, and tears went into making it. And it's fast and simple. So we're going to do the salad dressing right now. Then you're going to put it in the refrigerator. That's going to chill. And then we can make the other components.
Sounds good. I'm excited.
Yes.
Especially, you know, when you start making your own salad dressing, you're fancy. So,
yes, you
are. You know, you can always say, like...
And then you can bottle up and put it on the shelf.
That's what I was going to say. You know, bottle up, put your name on it.
By all means necessary.
Yes. Okay, so what do we need to get this dressing?
So I have rice.
What are we calling this dressing?
Raspberry vinaigrette.
Raspberry vinaigrette.
Yes.
Oh, that's good.
So we have olive oil, which I love. I have rice wine vinegar, and then you have raspberry, seedless raspberry jam.
Okay. So where can we find these items? I mean, I know raspberry jam, and then we have rice wine vinegar. So I don't know, can we find those in regular stores, or do we have to go to like Whole Foods?
No, a lot of these stuff is in our local food market. But the problem with a lot of people, they won't know because they always say the good stuff is on the outskirts and the junk is in the middle.
Yes.
So everybody goes straight to the middle and that's where all the stuff lands, in the middle. So it's like,
so
you don't give yourself a chance. A lot of things in the grocery store, but if you're not exposed to it, you won't know.
Alrighty, so let's get started with this dressing, I'm excited.
Yes. All right, so you're gonna take the raspberry jam. It's about 1 ounce, so you can put about 4 spoonfuls in there.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, you know when we're converting recipes and stuff and we're like, okay, 4 ounces. I know it's bad, like normal, regular people who are not chefs like you, we're like, wait, how many teaspoons or tablespoons?
See, it all depends on the mass and like this is very solid, so I never measure. I'm so sorry, I'm bad. I don't measure. Everything is just on instinct. That's why I love food and music. Food and music go hand in hand. Like, you just feel the music, you feel the vibe.
Exactly.
And cooking, I just feel it.
Yes.
You know, so I never measure, honestly.
I love
it. Put about 4 teaspoons, in there. And then we taste it as we need. If you need more, then you add more as you go.
That's real cooking.
Yeah. That's why I love cooking.
3, that's 4.
All right. And then this is the rice wine bin.
Okay.
You can pour all of that in there. That's about 4 ounces.
And this is like interesting.
It has basil and dried herbs in there.
Oh, and it always comes like that?
This one came like that.
Oh, this is amazing.
Yeah.
It smells really good.
It's delicious. Okay. And then you can put about 3/4 of the olive oil. Add that in there.
So we just...
I'm gonna tell you when it's
okay.
Deep at home, we have the directions. Keep going.
Is this extra virgin olive oil?
Yes, it is.
Okay, cool.
This is the one for salads.
I love this.
All right, that seems about good. And then put a pinch of salt and pepper.
Okay.
Usually I put about like 1 ounce of water just to loosen it up.
I
you never think it's oil and water or
This time it will.
Good.
You get your wrist action together.
Okay. I'm not really, you know, with me.
Yeah, very.
You try to chef it up.
Chef
you
it
know?
Up. Chef it up. A little elbow grease.
You know, you never really appreciate the stuff that you eat and you have until you have to make it.
Exactly.
And you're like, oh, I'll leave that up to you.
Yeah. This is what it takes. That's like before I started working in a restaurant, I used to just like go out and you have a long wait for food. You're not understanding why it takes so long. But
Right. Everything
is, when you go to a restaurant, it's made to order.
Exactly.
You have to wait. All right, that looks about good.
Okay.
Good. So now you can stick this in the fridge.
Cool.
And we get started on chopping up some greens.
All right, so we're gonna put this in the fridge for about how long?
About 15 minutes until it chills. By the time we finish chop this up, it should be fine. Plus, it's a glass bowl. So glass always makes it chill fast.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And the silver bowls too.
Okay.
So the glass bowls is good.
Glass and silver, all right.
Yeah.
So we're gonna put this in about 15 minutes or so?
15 minutes is fine.
All right.
So you chop the greens off, the tops, and I like to cut the butt off.
Oh, you know what? I always did that last.
Mm-mm.
See, this is why I'm not a chef.
For me, because it makes it easier for me.
Yeah.
But for some people that can't do it, then okay. And then just hold it. And just chop it.
It's a nice shred that you have going on here.
Yeah, chiffonade. Whole chiffonade.
Chiffonade.
Yeah.
Love it. Technique we're learning here.
Yes.
Technique.
And there you have it.
Okay.
And then these are mixed greens with red leaf, radicchio. And spinach.
Oh, and you know, we can find, it's like a spring mix?
Spring mix, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Like,
you can find
this
in your local, this has happened to be organic though.
Okay.
And it comes pre-packaged and it actually lasts longer because it's in the container. So this could probably last for like a week in your house.
Yeah.
In the refrigerator.
It lasts longer than the bag,
mm-hmm,
right?
Definitely, because the bag, it gets more wilted and turns brown and green and it's just nasty.
Yeah.
And you don't want to fix that. So you can add that to the bowl as well.
So we'll add this. I like the mixture of the two because this is more soft and the romaine gives it that crunch.
Exactly. Look at you. So how's your knife skills?
Well, you know, there we go. They're good.
All right, first we gotta crush some nuts. You know how to crush nuts?
I've never done that.
Before.
I usually just buy them already chopped.
Well, we're gonna chop them up today and get some frustration out of the nuts.
Okay, there we go.
All right, so you're just gonna take the knife and just go like this. And when you're cutting, never have your fingers out. Like, just always try to tuck your fingers.
So do your knuckles.
Yeah, your knuckles.
Oh, you know, that you learn something
new every day.
I definitely almost cut myself the other day.
So
is it like a motion like this?
It's
right?
All, everything is about the motion.
Okay. Okay. See, I cut like this.
That's
is that
fine.
Bad?
That's fine.
So we just put it on there?
Yeah, because we're going to mix it all up.
Okay.
All right, so now we have the mango. So we're just going to slice it. You just slice.
How do you know when it's a good mango?
I like to smell it.
Okay.
I like to smell the mango.
Wow. So you smell it and you like
you
touch
it
or something?
Yeah. When you
what
know
it
in the color. The color, if it's too green and a little bit of like the reddish, it's not good. You gotta be more reddish and the orangish type of color and then the softer. If I get it softer, that means I need it right away. The harder you bite, then the longer it has to stay until it gets ripe.
All right.
The strawberry, this is gonna be fairly easy. Okay, now we're gonna cut the apple. Leave the skin on because there's more nutrients in the apple skin.
Oh.
See how
really?
I cut it? Yeah.
Okay.
So I just cut the apple in half and then I just go up a little bit.
Okay.
And that takes
Oh, that's the core. The
core. Yep, see? So then I just slice it.
So did you have to make any salads or anything like that like this on Hell's Kitchen at all?
We did a lot of things. Half the stuff I can't remember. It was just so
it's such
much,
a blur.
Yeah, such a blur.
I mean, I can imagine there's so much pressure. You had to be under so much pressure doing that.
Life is a pressure.
Mm-hmm.
I just went in and I did it. The food is like fashion. The prettier it looks, the more you want to eat it. All right, so that's enough apples.
I would never think of this combination. Like, when you think of salad or you think fruit salad or you think like a salad without fruit. So like I would just never think this combination.
It's just all about balance and trying and seeing what works. You know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but as long as you know you put forth that effort and it's delicious. Like who doesn't like fruit? Now we're gonna cut the avocado.
This is interesting. I've never cut an avocado because of the pit in the middle. I'm so afraid.
So
And I'm like, do you have to cut around it?
Yeah, that's how you do it. Now feel it. You can't go no further. See that?
Oh yeah, there it is.
The pit is right there. So now what you do is you just go around. And the pit is right there. So you just go around.
There we go.
All right, so now we're just gonna add the cranberries.
Okay.
You can add that to it.
Dry, these are like dry cranberries?
Yeah, dry sweet cranberries.
And we can get these in any jar. They're like craisins.
Craisins.
And yeah, I was gonna say, I've
You get them anywhere. You get the dehydrated ones.
I wonder, have you ever done this yourself? Like, made them? Have you ever dried them yourself?
No, I never made it, but that's something I'm gonna get into. Like, yeah. I started learning raw foods, like I did vegan cooking.
Okay,
but I
wanna
get into the dehydration process and all of that.
Yeah, because you were a head chef at a vegan restaurant in Brooklyn.
In Brooklyn.
Yeah, how was that?
Amazing.
Did you make a lot of salads?
I made a whole lot of salads. I made a whole lot of veggie wraps. I had this one jerk wrap, which was delicious. Oh. I used to make paninis, pizzas, soups. Everything was organic. Everything was fresh.
And the funny thing is, you mentioned so many things that people eat, and people forget. Like, they say, oh, you know, these people are vegan or vegetarian. They're like, what do you eat? And you just named. You said pizza. You said, you know, jerk wrap. You know, all these things that you named. So
it's possible. I mean, it's microprotein, it's seitan. It's different forms of meat substitutes that you can eat and still taste good. It's all about the flavor.
Right.
So anything can be good, but it's all about how you do it. And vegetables, lots and lots of vegetables.
All right, so we put our cranberries in there.
Yeah, yes. So now I'm just gonna mix it up a little bit.
All right.
Build the salad up.
Okay, see, look, you see how she put that, like, just take notice. She put it on there and then built it there. You know what I mean?
We got fruits on the bottom, then have some more on top.
Okay, when you try to build this. Like, no, it didn't work for me.
It's okay. Just gotta hold it and build it up.
Wow. It's like a little
teepee.
Yeah, like a little teepee. I love it.
A little teepee. Then you get your apples and decorate.
Okay, now we have to dress it.
Dress it up.
Okay,
I love the creativity. Coming out, just play with it.
A little smiley face, you know?
Definitely. Food should be fun, it's healthy. And
I'm trying to chef it up here.
Chef it up with me. That's what you're doing. And look how pretty this is. And then, I don't like to put the salad dressing on it right away because it weighs down on the salad and then it gets soggy. So I like to plate it and have the salad dressing on the side, or we can drizzle some on top.
Like a little confetti, a little onion confetti.
It's the topper.
Make it rain.
Make it rain.
This is too much,
hilarious.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna put the salad dressing because it's nice and ready now.
Okay, here we go. I'm trying to make it drizzle. Help you live now and beyond. We're chefing it up today with Chef Nilka. I thank you so much for teaching us something so easy. It's pretty fast. This raspberry vinaigrette salad, we're about to go in. Like, there's no word for what's about to happen right now. So we are gonna dig in, and you know, if we're greedy, I don't know if I'm gonna share. But
and guess what? That was just the appetizer. Yes, Chef Nilka will be joining us yet again, and we'll be chefing up something I know you will really enjoy making. What she said. I'm Najla T. Make sure you're always living in the now.
I'm about to do the damn thing on the now with chefing it up with me. And no cursing.